Hello viewers, I am here with my next video on That Tempest. In this video, I will cover Act 2, Scene 2 from line 100 to 145. Up to line 100, we came to know that Stefano has come on the scene and he finds Caliban, under whose clock Trinculo lies hidden. Actually, Trinculo also was there in the same ship in which Stefano was travelling. After the shipwreck, they both got separated and reached on that island. They meet, but till now Stefano does not know that Trinculo is alive. So when he finds Caliban lying under a clock, and along with Caliban, Trinculo also is hidden. So here, when he sees that this person is having four legs, because one side it is the two legs of Caliban's and on the other side the two legs of Trinculo. So he thinks that it is a very weird kind of monster, and his forward voice speaks well of his friend, etc., etc. So now from line 100 we will start. Stefano in line 100 says, "Doth thy other mouth call me? Mercy, mercy. This is a devil and no monster. I will leave him. I have no long spoon." Actually, Trinculo has called Stefano. Because when Trinculo was hiding under the clock of Caliban, he hears Stefano talking, speaking something. So he recognizes his voice and he calls him by his name. So to hear his name from this monster, Stefano is afraid. And he thinks that this other mouth call me by my name. Oh my God, oh God, you please have mercy on me. Because he does not know that it is Trinculo. He still thinks that it is a monster who is calling him by his other mouth. So he thinks that this is a devil. It is not only a monster. So I should run away from here, because I don't have any long spoon to protect me. Long spoon refers to means I don't have any magic device by which I can protect myself from this devil. So there is a reference of long spoon. According to a superstitious belief, long spoon could help a man to keep the devil away from himself. So that's why he thinks that I don't have any protection against this devil. But Trinculo again speaks, "Stefano, if thou beest Stefano, touch me and speak to me, for I am Trinculo. Be not afeard, thy good friend Trinculo." So Trinculo recognizes him well by his sound. So therefore he says that, "Stefano, you need not be afraid of me, because I am your good friend Trinculo. And if you are not convinced, so you can touch me. By touching me, by speaking to me, you will understand that I am your good friend Trinculo." "Stefano, if thou beest Trinculo," it is line number 106, "if thou beest Trinculo, come forth. I will pull thee by the lesser legs. If any be Trinculo's legs, these are they." So Stefano is not able to understand this situation actually. Therefore, he speaks to, Trinculo now, that if thou beest Trinculo, if you are really Trinculo, you come out of this clock and show yourself. You just come in front of me face to face. "I will pull thee by the lesser legs." It means, he says that, let me pull you out by holding your thinner legs. Because he thinks that if it is Trinculo, his legs must be thinner in comparison to the thicker legs of Caliban on one side. So he says that, "I will pull you by these thinner legs," and then he pulls him out. He draws Trinculo out. "Thou art very Trinculo indeed." And to see Trinculo in front of him, he says, "Oh my God, you are really Trinculo. You are Trinculo indeed. So you let me know, how came you here? How did you reach here?" So it is a surprise for Stefano that Trinculo is alive. Then in line 110, Trinculo says, "I took him to be killed with a thunderstorm, but art thou not drowned, Stefano?" So Trinculo says, "Oh my God, I thought that you were killed in that storm, in that tempest. But what a big surprise for me that you were not drowned. I hope now thou you are not drowned." He says that, "Actually I hoped that you are not drowned, but I was not sure. Is the storm overblown?" So Trinculo is still having fear of storm. He asked him, "You let me know, Is the storm overblown? Means the storm has subsided or not? I hid me under the dead moon calf's gabardine for fear of the storm. So he tells that actually I was hiding here under the big clock of this monster just because of the fear of storm. I took shelter under his clock. And are thou living, Stefano? Oh, Stefano, two Neapolitans escaped. He says, it is still a big surprise for me that my dear friend Stefano is alive. So we two people from Naples are alive only. He thinks that rest others have died. So these two Neapolitans have been escaped from death. Then Stefano says, Preeti, do not turn me about. My stomach is not constant. Actually, in this line, we can understand that Trinculo is very happy to see Stefano. And he must have hugged him and tried to roll him. But Stefano feels uneasy. So therefore, he says that, please don't turn me about. Because my stomach is not constant. Please, I request you, I entreat you not to turn me round and round in this manner. My stomach is not stable and I am having some nauseatic feeling. So Caliban then overhears their conversation. So Caliban has been hearing both of them. He speaks aside, means apne aap se wo sochta hai. He speaks to himself. These be fine things, and if they be not spirits, that's a brave god and be a celestial liquor, I will kneel to him. So Caliban was actually till now afraid that these must be spirits sent by Prospero to tease him. But now he thinks that they are not supernatural beings. They are not sent by Prospero. So they must be some adorable fellows. The one who carries a bottle in his hand must be a handsome god. He seems to be a brave god and he is having a heavenly drink in his hand. So I will kneel to him. Kneel matlab, I will surrender to him. I will be very happy to become his slave. Actually, Caliban is very much impressed to see that heavenly drink in his hand. Stefano, how didst thou escape? Line number 120. Stefano says, how didst thou escape? How camest thou hither? Swear by this bottle, how thou camest here? So Stefano wants to know how Trinculo could save himself. So again and again he asks him, sorry, you let me know that how you reached here. I escaped upon a butt of sand, which the sailors heaved overboard. He tells about his own escape. He narrates how he himself was saved. He says that, as for me, I escaped drowning by getting hold on a huge barrel of wine. So, sorry. Which I made of the bark by this bottle, which I made of the bark of a tree with my own hands since I was cast ashore. So he swears by that bottle that he is holding in his hand. He says that I am telling you the truth by swearing this bottle, because this bottle is made with my own hands by using the bark of a tree when I came here after being swept over. So he says that when I reached on this ashore, so I just took the bark of a tree and made this bottle with my own hands. So since I have made it with my own hands, so this bottle is holy to me. So I swear by this and tell you the truth that this way I was saved. Then Caliban speaks, I will swear upon that bottle to be thy true subject, for the liquor is not earthly. So before Trinculo could make any answer, Caliban interferes. He says that, sir, I will swear by this bottle. I am also ready to swear by this bottle and claim that I am very happy to meet you. So I am ready to be your true subject. Means I am ready to be your loyal or faithful subject. That means Caliban is very happy to be the slave of Stefano. And why he is ready to be the slave? Because the liquor is not earthly. Because Caliban is influenced by that wine, which seems to him not an earthly substance. He thinks that it is something heavenly, that's why I am ready to be your slave. Stefano, how? Swear then, how thou escapest? Stefano once again asks, then you let me No Trinculo, how you escaped? You just swear by this bottle and tell me how you escaped drowning. Then Trinculo says, swim ashore, man, like a duck. I can swim like a duck, I will be swan. So Trinculo makes a very ridiculous remark. He says that, yes sir, I swam like a duck. Okay, I know swimming. I am an excellent swimmer because I can swim like a duck. So I swam and reached on the shore. So I can swear that I can swim as good as a duck can. Stefano here kissed the book, gives Trinculo drink. Stefano offering him some drink and say that you kiss the book. Actually book refers to the book of Bible. But they are not having the book of Bible. So he thinks that this bottle is as holy as Bible. So he tells Trinculo that to touch this bottle and take it as holy Bible and then swear and tell me how could you come like a duck? Because you are not born like a duck, you are a goose. You are not born like a duck. Means you cannot swim as a duck because you have the appearance of a goose. Then Trinculo says, oh Stefano, has any more of this? So after drinking wine, Trinculo demands Stefano some more wine. He says that, do you have some more wine? Stefano says, the whole but. Man, my cellar is in a rock by the seaside where my wine is hid. Line number 136, you can see. The whole but. Stefano assures him that I have enough stock of wine. I have got a whole barrel full of wine and I have hidden it in a rock by the seaside. So he says that this place is in the rock and there is my wine cellar. So he turns to Caliban now. How now, Mooncalf? He calls him Mooncalf. Mooncalf matlab deformed creature. He calls him that, oh deformed creature, how are you? How now, how does thine orb? Means how is your fever now? Actually fever is the reference because when Stefano reached there, he found Caliban shaking. Actually, Caliban was shaking in fear because he thought that this must be some spirit sent by Prospero. So that's why he asked him, Stefano thought that he must be having fever or some kind of physical trouble. So he asked him, what is your condition now? How is your shaking now? Caliban says, has thou not dropped from heaven? Caliban still is not able to believe that this can be a normal human being, normal creature. So he asked him again and again, if I think that you are fallen from heaven or you are a divine figure, so can I believe it? You do not belong to the earth. I feel that you have dropped from the heaven above. Stefano says, out of the moon, I do assure thee, I was the man in the moon when time was. Stefano takes advantage of his foolishness. Already Caliban has offered to be his slave. So Stefano thinks that, yes, I assure you that I have dropped from the moon, which is in the sky. He tells him that I was the man whom the people used to see in the moon. Actually about moon, there are some beliefs that moon ke upar jo craters hain, actually these craters in those days were thought to be some creatures sitting on the moon. So he says that actually I am the moon, I have come down from the moon and I am the man who is seen by the people sitting in the moon. Caliban says, I have seen thee in her and I do adore thee. Caliban believes him. He says, oh yes, I have seen you there in the moon and that's why I adore thee. Means I admire you, I worship you. My mistress showed me thee and thy dog and thy bush. Actually, my mistress showed me that you are sitting there in the moon along with your dog and your bush. So I have seen you along with your dog and the bush growing by your side. So yes, I know you. You are the man from the moon. So Caliban is convinced that Stefano has come down from sky. Stefano says, come swear to that. Kiss the book. I will furnish it anon with new contents. Swear. So Stefano in line number 145, he says that if you think like this, so come and swear by this book. Book again refers to bottle. So you touch this bottle and swear and say the truth that yes, you believe I am the man from moon. If you take an oath and state your assures me about your statement, so I will furnish it, means I will fill this bottle again with the heavenly drink. So this way he gives Caliban some drink, he offers him some more drink. That's all in this video up to line number 145. Thank you viewers for watching this video. I hope it is informative for you and it will help you to understand the tempest. Thank you once again.